I thought it was a combination of quite a few things, because I always used to think, I don't work for the Disney store, like, as in the shop. I think a lot of people had that mentality, that it was just a part-time job for them, it was just a shop, and that was all they thought about. But I didn't look at it like that. I worked for the Walt Disney Company. That was what I thought. I took real pride in that, and thinking that I work for this company, it's one of the best companies in the world, does so many great things, makes so many great movies, and I work for them. I am part of that.
It's a much easier product to sell as well, isn't it? People come in because they're looking for a bit of Disney in their life.
Yeah.
You go into other shops on the...
It's very easy to be enthusiastic.
Yeah, you're in any other shops on the high street, it's like they're looking for a t-shirt or a pair of jeans or something simple. You come in, they're looking for the experience in Disney Store.
I always say, if Disney Store paid what a lawyer pays, I would definitely still be there. Doing that. I have also looked at being a lawyer for Disney at some points, but unfortunately I don't want to live in London.
It's like going to another shop. You go to another store and the customer service compared to what we give guests is totally different.
They practically run away from people rather than approach people.
Yeah, whereas we were still hands-on and the guest was everything. And you did enjoy the interaction and it made their day as well as it made ours.
I would say like 98% of the people that worked there because they wanted to have a job that was slightly different, had some sort of magic in it. We'll be singing when we're winning. We'll be singing. I get no
It was one of these years where everything seemed to be coming together. It was like there was Britpop, there was Aces, there was Blur. And all these people were like such big figures at that time, and pop music was pop music at that time. You also had like Britney Spears and Steps and all these kind of things. It was real. Pop music, it was no faceless things like it is now, so.
I was six.
Oh God, go away.
I don't remember much from when I was six.
Is Escape 7 good? I like Escape 7.
Yes.
Oh, Craig and I just got married in June.
That was such an afterthought, wasn't it?
I know, so
Lady Diana passed away. That's the only thing that I can remember from 1997.
Good evening. Britain lost a princess today. A young woman described by all to whom she reached out as irreplaceable.
I do remember going to see Titanic though. Got a funny story, I'll tell you.
That was in 98 though. So.
Oh, 97. I just looked it up.
No, but I never came out here till early 98 because I was working in the store when it came out. I totally remember it. It was made in 97, came out here in January 98.
Oh well, won't tell you the story then.
Yeah, for me, I was a stay-at-home mum and I was quite happy staying at home. And a friend had said, oh, Disney are looking for cast members and she was going to apply for it. And I was like, that's something I really, really want to do.
I was in Edinburgh from about April 97 in the Princess Street store. I'd got the job in Dundee, but I was doing my training in Edinburgh prior to coming through to Dundee.
Yeah, for me it was a job that I really wanted as well. I saw it in the paper. There was an article saying that Disney Store was coming to Dundee before the jobs were advertised. So I kept an eye out for the jobs being advertised. And straight away sent away for that application. Quite excited and hopeful.
I think the reason I came for the job was I'd been to Edinburgh and I'd been in the Disney store in Edinburgh and they had said, why don't you come and work for us? And I thought, something I'd never ever thought about before. And I thought, maybe could do that. And then obviously I saw the advert in the paper a few weeks afterwards and saw they were looking for not just full-time staff, but also for part-time staff. And I thought, well, that could suit me. I could work my weekends around that.
Remember the group interviews, because it was quite daunting, the amount of people. When you go for an interview, you think it's sort of a one-to-one situation. So it's completely different, but they made you feel at ease.
Yeah.
It's good.
Oh, it was fun.
It was fun, yeah.
What was it called? Shark? Was it Shark Island or the shark thing when you're all got on the piece of paper?
Oh, yeah.
It was called Shark something. Something.
Putting
two
everybody
days
on a bit of paper.
Yeah, the sharks. Shark game, yeah.
Trying to put on a bit of 84 paper. That sums up traditions for
that's
me.
That's pretty much all I remember as well.
But the name game was the best.
Yeah,
the introduction
name game.
Name game, which David has never looked down.
No, I got my nickname from that day, so.
The first person had to say, my name's Fiona and my favourite character's Goofy, and then the next person would say their name and their favourite character, and then they'd also say what the person next to them had said. So eventually it would go around the circle and everybody would have a name and a character and you'd know who everybody was. So David said,
I'm David and my favourite character is the Beast.
But by the time everybody else had said it and it got back to the start, it was, and this is David the Beast.
Which stuck. It stuck for a long time. I even had that on my name badge at one point, but that had to get removed because it wasn't very PC having David the Beast on a name badge, so it sounded a bit wrong.
So yeah, when did little role plays as well, where you had to be a customer, and did you have to learn the Disney point? I can't remember.
I think it was a time that I do remember after traditions thinking, this is like amazing, this company is amazing. All the things, and I remember them giving us watches and that. I remember coming
and
home
t-shirts.
Thinking,
well,
I got
the
a watch.
Store
I got a watch and a t-shirt.
I'm pretty sure I still have my life.
I still have my life. I was offered a 12-hour contract, and it said you've been invited to 2 days traditions at the Hilton Hotel. And it said about you'd be supplied with a costume, and it was really exciting.
But I do remember the letter came through the door, and I had obviously had the Disney Store on the envelope. And it was quite a thick letter, so I thought, it's not a no then. Hopefully it's not a no. I remember opening and I had about 3 or 4 pages and there were different things about what you had to do for the company and whatever, and that, etc. So, and I just remember saying to people, oh my God, I got it, I can't believe it. So.
I started at 8 o'clock in the store. I remember cleaning the tiles, washing all the tiles, and making it all look nice.
There was quite a few different things that I remember over the day. I was in the store, but there was the character breakfast in the Hilton, and there was also a thing in the City Square as well.
Yeah.
So where they had some characters in the City Square, and people could meet the characters there as well, I think.
I think you could do one or the other. You could either go to the breakfast, or you could be in the City Square.
I remember feeling quite overwhelmed, like how many people were you expecting, and this was kind of new for me, you know, the guest service experience, and it was a bit daunting. All these people were going to come. And then I spent the rest of the day in between cash and wrap and a pillar saying to everybody, please would you mind going round this way? Please would you mind going round this way? And I did that from 9 o'clock till about 3:30 when I said to somebody, am I getting a lunch? And they were like, oh, we totally forgot about you. Totally forgot about me. So I got to finish an hour early. So
I finished an hour early and everybody else as well. So I'd been at the breakfast, the character breakfast at the Hilton. So that was the start of my day. I had breakfast with Pluto, Mickey, Minnie, and who else was it? Goofy.
Goofy.
Yeah,
Goofy was there.
Yeah. So that was fab. But we made it up to the store for the store opening. It was really quite exciting, I thought.
Yeah,
everybody was really hyper.
It's just a big blur, really. Like, everybody was really, really excited. It didn't feel like we were just opening a shop. It really did feel like we were being part of a sort of event.
Yeah.
Because Homebase had really, their events, people kind of organised all this above and beyond the fact that they were opening a store. And they were all there. It was just a big blur from morning to, I don't even remember what it was like when we closed. Yeah. I think
I just remember how busy it was. Yeah. I've never seen so many people jammed into that space. Because I think at one point they were letting so many people in, so many people out, because it was just so unbelievably busy. And you were kind of like, if you were trying to work that day, it was like you were trying to squeeze past everybody and
running up and downstairs and
mayhem,
get stuff.
Absolute mayhem.
Made sure everybody had their rakes and nobody. Yeah, there was always someone on the door. We had two greeters on the door, just saying hello to everybody. And of course, it's the first time ever in Dundee that somebody stood at a door and went, "Hello, how are you?" And people were going, "Bah," at them.
That went very strange for the first few months. Everybody would be kind of like, "Strange, do I know you? Why are you speaking to me?" But someone that was never happened in Dundee before, so never.
Unless it was security, but that would be a different hello. I think we just all collapsed, didn't we? And took that. Well, I took that picture. I wonder if everybody kind of lying on what was left of Flush Mountain at the end of the day. So they were like, "Oh yeah, we're done."
Joined the Disney Store in 2006. I'd just finished school and was about to start my law degree at uni, and a position for a Christmas temp came up. I've always loved Disney, so I applied and I started in the Christmas of 2006 as a Christmas temp.
I just moved back from Glasgow and I was looking for a job, and there was a job in the window, and my friends were like, "Why don't you go and apply for that?" And I was like, "I don't know." I was like, "That's a kid shop. How could I apply there?" Not knowing that 16 years on, I'm still in the same place. So applied for it, got one interview, which was a group interview. Went really well. Got a phone call back saying, "We want you back for another interview." So we got back for another interview, and then by the Friday I found out I had the job.
I joined in October 2003. Yeah, that's right. 2003, Christmas temp, group interview with Fiona Flockhart, store manager then. I had to sell a Bell Nighty to the rest of the group. Then I got asked to come back and I had to do a pre-sale. I was asked to sell a pre-sale.
Sold your dad a pre-sale?
Yeah, I think it was 100 divisions I had to pre-sale. And then, the rest is history. So. You don't think you... If someone said to me I'd be there for 14 years, I would never have thought
it. You don't. It doesn't feel like it either,
no.
Does it?
I thought Christmas temp that was it, but no.
It's amazing, isn't it?
I got hired in... must have been August of 2008. Nikki actually got me the job. She... I don't know. Can't remember how.
Nikki's fault.
It was Nikki's fault. He's got subjected to me. All I remember is going in to meet Colin for my interview, and it was literally what's your costume size, and we'll start you as soon as.
Great.
So
I know. We're all like that, mate.
Okay. I see what's happening. Yeah. Face to face with greatness, and it's
but I think what makes working there special as opposed to working in like another multinational is the people that work there. It's definitely the cast.
Definitely. I think the whole thing about being on the stage really kind of hypes you up. Everyone's in a good mood there, everyone's having a good time. The customers that come in are really happy. The kids are so excited to be there.
See, I now work in another retail store, so then I find out it's a lot different. Where I am now is a lot different because they're not, they say they're customer focused, but they're really not. Like, I go daily routine at work, and I don't think I can count on one hand the amount of times people have said hi to customers. Like, I'm normally the one that says hi to the people that are coming into the store, which I got accredited for, they acknowledged me for that, but they were just like, "Yeah, everybody does that," and I'm like, no, they don't.
So we were there to spread the magic, which was remember all the maintain your presence, assess your guest, greet, individualise and conclude. So that's what we aim to do each time somebody came through the door.
With every introduction.
Yes.
And that kind of came through, especially with the opening cast, came through as big family.
Yeah, I think it's always been the case. I've always said that Disney is family, and it sounds a bit cheesy, but yeah, it's true. And I think a lot of people that worked there for a long time, you just have to look at some of the people, how long they worked there, 15 years, 10 years, 6 years, whatever. Now, people didn't come and go like you see in a normal shop or store where people just come and then they're just there for a few months and then they leave again, whatever. Now, people stayed. People stayed. And yeah, like it was a great cast. It was a great sort of family.
We're still speaking even after Indeed, yes.
And everybody, we say it's our Disney family.
Mm-hmm.
And as you say, most people don't stay in touch with other people. I was in retail before, and off the top of my head, I can't think of anybody that I would still be in touch with.
Yeah, it's a family. And for me, it's always been the people that I've worked with that makes it my home. And thank you!
I think I kind of knew it was coming in some way or other. I think I kind of thought it's going to happen because I kind of know the way the company thought, and I kind of think, I don't think the sort of look to the future and think, oh, Dundee's an up-and-coming place, we've got the V&A coming and everything else. I don't think they think that way, unfortunately.
I know there's a lot of people that was part of their routine, was to come in and have a chat, and a lot of people with special needs. That would come in on a daily basis and we would have a chat with them. So I think it'll be missed from that point of view as well. So it was a social place.
It's still not 100% sunk in yet.
No,
that it's actually happened. Like you walk past and you see that it's not there anymore and got new jobs and blah, 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 but it still doesn't feel like, it feels
real.
Like we're just on holiday.
Yeah.
Quite sad actually, but a lot of childhood memories there, and kind of a bit sad for the staff members that were like had been there since the beginning and who are there now, and also for all the kids in Dundee, because even just walking down the Money Gate, seeing it was always excitement, so it's a shame that the kids are going to miss out on that.
Yeah, it's a shame. I do feel sorry for the cast in that as well.
Definitely.
I think it shows you the level of Disney in that as well when you think that all the people, how affected they've been by it, people that haven't worked there for such a long time and they still say, oh my God, that's awful, and they feel really bad about it because it was so important to them. I think that is a big thing. So.
Do you know, it was emotional because it's like that was our store and now there's nothing there at all.
You've grown up there. I was 19, now I'm 33. You know, that's a big thing. It's your whole life.
Your memories, your sad times, your happy times.
And it was you didn't choose.
Fun times, yeah.
Yeah, you didn't choose this. No one chose this.
It's an end of an era, isn't it?
Yeah. Like she loved me when she
somebody loved me, everything was beautiful. Every hour we spent together lives within my heart. When she
tell me I ain't no fun. Just tell me you love me, like I love you. You know you do. When we're together, gray skies clear up, and I cheer up to where I'm less depressed. And sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, I just can't take it. Belong together. We belong together. Yes, we do. You be mine forever. We belong together. We belong together. You know it's true. It's gonna stay this way. I could find a way. I'm not shy. There's a whole lot I wanna say. Of course there is. Talk about friendship and loyalty. Talk about how much you mean to me. And I promise to always be by your side whenever you need me. The day I met you was the luckiest day of my life. And I bet you feel the same. I hope you do. So don't forget me if the future should take you away. Cause you'll always be part of me. We belong together. We belong together. Wait and see. Don't be this way forever.
Chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax, let us pull up a chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest, put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, chérie, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre, why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France, and a dinner here is never second best. Go on, unfold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest.
Beef ragout, cheese souffle, pie and pudding
on flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy.
Yeah, I've got one quite frightful memory when John, on one of the delivery shifts, after carrying heaps of boxes up and down the stairs, jumped out of a big giant ER box and absolutely scared the living daylights out of me. So yeah, that's quite an exciting memory.
VH1 MTV.
I know, we used to have mixtapes and everything.
Mega mixes.
So, yeah, until Barry came in and we put his music on.
Yeah, was there not? You had the videos on. You used to do your recording.
Used to do the videos,
videos,
yeah.
Of like all the music
CD
panels.
UK. Yeah.
Yeah.
Roddy standing at the front door with the giant poo bear.
And how many did he go through? Because the arms, did all the stuff when they come out the arm, because he shook it so much, it was like
Pocahontas.
Good character.
I just said Pocahontas.
Lotso, because I love strawberries and he smells of strawberries. And he's mean and so am I sometimes.
Yeah.
That, do you know what, I watched Lion King just the other day. It's got to be one of the best. But yeah, depending on my mood, what you would want to watch.
Well, my badges have had a few different ones, but it's been Boo, I think, probably for the last 10 years.
So my favourite character used to be the Beast. Probably Doug is my favourite character now.
Probably my ultimate favourite Disney movie is The Rescuers. Because I can still... I know the soundtrack and the dialogue off by heart.
But yeah, I think over all the years, I think it was really the people made it. Yeah. Absolutely the people made it. So, and the fact we were all just like one big family.
Onwards and upwards.
Yeah, so we're always going to have Disney in our heart. Yeah. And we're always going to see each other.
That's it.